So now it's time to order website hosting. And website hosting is essentially you renting space on a computer that's accessible to the internet, and that's where your website's going to be, that's where your email accounts are going to be, and all of that. And I'm going to walk you through this whole process. Now, what you need to link into your website hosting is also called a domain name, and that's where someone will type your website address and it will take them over to your hosting account. Now, typically these are both ordered at the same place, and we're going to do that right now in this video. Now, I want to talk about hosting because you might already have hosting, and that's okay, but there are certain web hosting providers that are just not good. And for this website journey that we're going on together, you're going to want a quality web hosting provider. So there are plenty that are not quality, and I want to just list some of them off right now. First of all, if you have GoDaddy, it's not going to work for you in this situation. GoDaddy, when you have hosting with them, they force certain components on your website that are just going to cause problems with any type of e-commerce website or any website like an online course website, because they force these caching solutions on your website. And that might be a little beyond what I want to talk about right now in this video, but this thing called caching, it's going to cause all kinds of headaches for you. Plus, when your website is on with their service, it tends to run a little slower than you would want your website to run. So one of the most important things with website hosting is how fast your website's going to load for your visitor, and it's just not going to be a great experience with GoDaddy. And the same can be said of HostGator and Bluehost. Both of them are really known for having poor support and very slow servers. Early in 2017, in fact, Bluehost was down for 4 days. HostGator, which, whether you knew it or not, is the same company, that's the same parent company, they were down for 4 days as well. So everyone that had their websites on those services, which is quite a few websites, they were all completely shut out of business for days. Plus, there's just a lot of issues with those providers, so I don't recommend them. Now, who I do recommend is Inmotion Hosting, and I have a special link right here that will take you right over to their website, or right now you can enter ordernewhosting.com. So just visit the website ordernewhosting.com and it will take you right over to Inmotion's website. Now, they have arranged a big discount for my viewers of my YouTube channel. It's a 57% discount. Now, I'm going to tell you right now, you will not find a larger discount on Inmotion Hosting, nor will you find a larger discount for any web hosting provider. There are a lot of reasons to go with Inmotion that I'll tell you about here in a moment, but also what I'm doing is, if you do order a new web hosting account via ordernewhosting.com or through a link on my website, I'm going to throw in an additional bonus. So if you notice on my website, I have a large course catalog, and I've put together a special bundle for you. Essentially for you, it's going to be a course on the page builder we're using. It's going to be a course on creating courses and all the tech behind it, the audio, the video, building everything out, pricing strategy, all that. You're going to get a course on that. You're going to get all of my essentials courses, which are $97 a piece. Altogether, when you add it all up, it's about $600. And my custom training courses that are really going to launch you in this online course building journey, I'm going to give that to you as a free gift when you order hosting through Inmotion. Now, when you do order Inmotion Hosting, they do give me a small referral fee, and that's the reason I'm going to give you these courses as a bonus, because number one, I really want you to sign up for Inmotion. They pay me a little bit of money. And number two, I really want you to be successful in building this online course platform for yourself. So I want to give you all the tools to make sure that can happen for you. So here are some of the great benefits of Inmotion Hosting. Number one, I love their support. You can pick up the phone and call them. You can reach them via live chat. You can also submit a support ticket. So those are some of the main things I like about them. The second big thing I like about them is that your website's going to be hosted on a server that has solid state drive. All that means is your site is going to run very, very fast. And there's lots of other things to like about Inmotion. One of the things I really like is when you install WordPress, they don't make all this junk get installed along with it. That's what happens when you use HostGator or Bluehost or any of that family of web hosts. Whenever you install WordPress, they install three or four or five junk plugins that you have to then go in and remove. So there are a few caveats with Inmotion Hosting. When you order via their website, they only take a credit card. However, if you can't pay with a credit card and you can only pay with a PayPal account, you can actually contact their live chat and they will set you up to make a payment with PayPal. Now, when you do that, you need to tell them that you were referred by WP Crafter. If you don't tell them that, then it won't get added to the order and I won't be able to give you the course bundle. And the only other caveat is those situations where you want to register a domain name that's not a .com or a .net or a .org, some different type of extension for your domain name. In those scenarios, you'll have to order the domain name someplace else. I recommend Namecheap.com, and then you can link that domain name in with Inmotion. And if that's a little over your technical head, that's okay. You can contact me on my website, and I will help you with that. But essentially, you just head over to Namecheap, pick your domain name there, and then order your hosting with Inmotion, and then you can contact me and I will help you link up the two. But I think Inmotion will also link up the two for you. So essentially, you have these three plans to choose from. And the main difference between these plans is how many websites you can host on it. So with the launch plan, you're going to be able to have two websites. The power plan, you'll be able to have six websites. And the pro plan has unlimited websites. Now, also with the pro plan, there are a bit more resources allocated to your website. So you'll have more memory and stuff like that available for your websites as they need it. But if you're just getting started, you can go with this launch plan. Now, the plan I have with them is the pro plan myself, but you can do whatever you feel comfortable with. So the greater discount is with the launch plan. Now, right now, when you click on the order button, you just choose the term, whether you want to prepay for 1 year, 2 years, or 3 years. Keep in mind, there are always optimizing their website here, so some of this checkout process might change. I know this drop down with the term is a new thing that they are testing, so I'm going to go ahead and click on order now, and I'm just going to go ahead and choose 1 year. And what it does is it's going to open up in a new tab, and then it's going to initialize their secure checkout portal. So you can see right here, the cost would have been $107, but because of the discount, it brings it down to only $53. Now that discount gets larger and larger the longer you want to order hosting with them. So the first thing you need to do is if you decide if you want to order a new domain name or if you already have a domain name that you want to use with this hosting package. So a domain name is essentially just your website address. So what you'd want to do is enter your domain name here and then choose whether you want it to be a .net or .org or any of these extensions. And this is what I was talking about earlier. If you want an extension that's not in this list, just go ahead and register it at namecheap.com and then you can link the two together. In that case, you would choose I already own a domain. Or if you already have a domain and you just want to use it with the hosting, you would choose that as well. So I already own my domain. But what happens is if you are registering a domain name through this process and you enter it in, it's first going to check to see if it's available. So let me enter a domain name in to show you. Now, I already own the domain name show the demo. So if I did that, it's going to show that it's taken. Let's just see what that looks like. Show the demo. I'm going to do a quick search and it's going to show that it's taken. So I know if I add the one, it's not going to be taken. So I'm going to do a search again and it's going to probably show me that this is available. There it is. It is available. And it's also given me other options of different versions of it. And you could choose that if you want. It's up to you if you want to lock in all the different variations of the domain name that you get. So go ahead and click on Add to Cart, and then the domain name is going to be added to the order. Okay, there we see the domain name is added to the order, and you're going to see that you get the domain name for free. Now, normally, to register a domain name, you can see here it's $15, and that's pretty typical. Namecheap's about $11, and just want to let you know that you also get that included in that cost. Now, they're automatically adding domain privacy, and we can remove it with this X right here. What that means is it's just kind of like way back in the day we used to have the white pages, and that is when you would get a phone number, it would go into the white pages, and then anyone can have a white pages and they can look up and see what your phone number is. So if you didn't want to be in the white pages, you would actually have to pay some sort of a fee each month so that you weren't in the white pages. So that's kind of what domain privacy is. Whenever you register a domain name, your name and address and phone number get tagged to that, also an email address. Now, if you do domain privacy, it will be hidden information. So when someone looks up the domain name, they won't be able to see who's registered it and who actually owns it. So it's up to you if you want domain privacy or not. So for the case of this video, I'm just going to go ahead and click on the X and remove it, and that will bring the cost back down to that $53. So now let's just go ahead and click on continue again. And it just wants to make sure that you didn't do that by accident, and it's offering you the domain name privacy again. I'm going to go ahead and click on continue because we don't want that in this situation. Now, this is a notice to see if you want to pay a little more for the larger plan, the ability to have more websites. I talked about that just a moment ago, where you can have 6 websites versus the 2 we're getting with this plan. You could take them up on their offer or just click on no thanks and stick with the one that you have. Okay, so now we just need to choose which data center we want. I would recommend using the East Coast because that's a good central part of the world and the data centers over there are lightning quick. This might have really mattered 10 years ago when the internet was much younger, but nowadays it really wouldn't matter which one you chose, but I would just suggest going with the East Coast. No matter which country or continent you're on, East Coast is probably going to serve you the best. And right here, it's offering to install WordPress for you. We're going to do that manually because I want to just show you how it's done. So just choose on no thanks. If you do accidentally choose on it, it's going to kind of mess up the flow of what we're doing here in this video series. So just keep it on no thanks. And then we're going to go ahead and click on continue, and it's just going to prompt you here to go ahead and create an account. What's really nice, if you have multiple hosting accounts, you can link them all together through one login. So for me, I would just log in right here, but you're probably a new customer, so I'm going to go ahead and enter in a new email as if I was a new customer. Okay, I've just entered in an email. I'm going to go ahead and click on continue. All right, now all you need to do is essentially fill out your billing information right here. It's all pretty standard. And then down here, you're going to choose your payment method, and it's essentially putting in your credit card information, and then click on review my order, and then complete your checkout. Now, one important thing to make sure you add when you're filling this out is this part right here where it says referred by optional. And what I need you to put there, this is just a precautionary measure just to make sure that the order gets tagged properly so I can get you access to that $600 course bundle. I need you to enter in WPCrafter, just like that, WPCrafter, one word. And if you enter that there like that, they will definitely know that you came through my website, and it will just clear up any confusion if there does happen to be any in the future. And so I'd really appreciate if you just do that for me, enter in WP Crafter right there. And that will just make sure that they are crystal clear how you got to their website. And like I said, this benefits me a little bit. I earn a little bit of money, and that allows me to give you that large course bundle that will put you on the right track with building out your WordPress-based website. Now, remember, like I said in the beginning of this section of this video, if you only have PayPal, you'll just want to contact them via live chat. And you can even actually pick up the phone and place an order if that's something that you feel more comfortable with. Some people definitely feel more comfortable doing that. Now, if you do, make sure you let them know that WP Crafter is who referred you so that I can get those bonus courses to you. So just go ahead and fill out this information and then review your order and then submit your order. And then what's going to happen is you are going to receive several emails. I do know that randomly they verify your order, so it might take you to a screen when you finish your checkout where they say that they're going to call you to verify your order. This is actually a very standard practice with web hosting, and you'll just have to wait for that to happen. It usually takes about 20 to 30 minutes for them to get on the phone to call you. But you're going to receive a couple emails. One will be a receipt, and it will have your order number in it, and it starts with the letters IMH. Now, that is the order that I need you to send to me in order for me to verify your purchase was actually through my website and then get you access to the courses. So I'm going to need you to forward that off to me. Now, I have instructions on that on my website. It's right here. Let's see. When you go to contact, this would be the best thing. Go to contact and then click on course access. And it's basically saying just go ahead and email that receipt over to me so I can verify it. Now, you're also going to receive a second email, and it's going to say click this button to set up your password. Now, it's going to take you over to Inmotion's website, and you are essentially going to create a password for your account. Now, your login name will be the email address you used when you ordered your hosting, and the password will be whatever you set. So we're going to need that information to move forward. So once you have your hosting login, you can move forward in this video series.